Hi there, I'm Nico, your friendly neighborhood Cape Fox and Derail Valley modder. Today we're going to be talking about how to install mods for Derail Valley Simulator. First up, installing Unity Mod Manager. To install Unity Mod Manager, we'll first need to download it. We can find Unity Mod Manager at nexusmods.com/site/mods/21, or you can click the link down in the video description. Once we're here, we'll hop over to the Files tab, choose Manual Download and Slow Download, and then we'll save that to the desktop. Once you've downloaded the Unity Mod Manager archive, double-click it to open it up. Inside, you'll find a folder called Unity Mod Manager Installer. You can extract this folder anywhere you'd like. I've extracted mine into the Games folder inside my user directory, and I've created a shortcut for the main executable. Once you've launched the Unity Mod Manager installer, open the game dropdown and choose Derail Valley. The folder option may or may not default to your Derail Valley install directory. If it doesn't, simply click here to open the game path selector. If you don't know where to find your Derail Valley install directory, open Derail Valley in your Steam library, click the cog button, go down to Manage, and choose Browse Local Files. You'll now see the full path to your Derail Valley install directory in the address bar. We'll go back to the Browse for Folder window and browse for the Derail Valley install directory. For me, that's on the C drive in Program Files x86, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Derail Valley, and we'll choose OK. Now that we've selected Derail Valley as the game and told Unity Mod Manager where it's installed, all we have left to do is make sure doorstop proxy is selected as the installation method and click the install button. We can see now that the in-game version of Unity Mod Manager is 0.27.3.0. And now we're ready to install mods. First up, we'll install a code mod. To install a code mod, we'll first need to download it. The Derail Valley modding community uses Nexus to distribute our mods. You can find all the mods for Derail Valley at nexusmods.com/derailvalley, or click the link in the video description. We'll use Skin Manager as our demonstration mod. You'll know that a mod is up to date for Simulator and Unity Mod Manager if the last updated date is July 22nd, 2023 or later. To download it, we'll go to the Files tab and choose Manual Download. I'm recording this video before we make the switch from BepInEx to Unity Mod Manager. That's why it says this mod requires BepInEx. When you download it, it should say it requires Unity Mod Manager. We'll choose the download option and then choose Slow Download. Now we won't be downloading this archive because this version is made for a different mod loader, but you would choose to save the archive in a convenient location such as the desktop or downloads folder. Katie Cat was kind enough to provide me with a preview of the version of Skin Manager mod that should be available once this video is live, so we'll be installing that instead. In the Unity Mod Manager installer window, we'll choose the Mods tab, then we'll drag and drop the Skin Manager mod archive into the Drop Zip Files Here portion of the window. We can see that Skin Manager was successfully installed. Now that we know how to install code mods, we'll learn how to install content mods. To install a content mod, we'll first need to download it. Again, we'll know that a mod is up to date for Simulator and Unity Mod Manager if the last updated date is July 22nd, 2023 or later. Also, again, I'm recording this video early, which is why the last updated date is different here. To download this skin, we'll go to the Files tab, choose Manual Download, Download, and Slow Download, and we'll save it to the desktop. Content mods for Derail Valley Simulator and Unity Mod Manager get installed differently than they did for Derail Valley Overhauled or Derail Valley Simulator with the BepInEx mod loader. To install a content mod for Derail Valley Simulator with Unity Mod Manager, simply drag the content mod archive to the Unity Mod Manager installer window and drop it where it says Drop Zip Files Here. We can verify that the skin is working in the game. We'll open the comms radio to the spawner mode and spawn a DE2, and we can see that it has the skin applied. We can also see that the skin is available in the comms radio reskin menu. Now that we've seen how to install a content mod, we'll learn how to configure mods. We configure mods using the Unity Mod Manager in-game UI. Unfortunately, this isn't available in VR. The Unity Mod Manager UI may pop up automatically when you start the game, but if it doesn't, we can open it by holding Control and pressing F10. This opens the Unity Mod Manager window. Here, we can configure mods. We'll click the settings icon next to a mod that supports it. The Skin Manager gives us some configuration options. For instance, if we want the default DE2 skin to appear by random chance, even though we've installed a replacement, we can choose Random for All Cars is under the default skin usage setting, and then choose Save. Now when we spawn a DE2, there's a chance that the default skin will be used. Let's switch the default skin usage to Prefer Reskins, so we can talk about disabling mods. Some mods can be disabled directly in the game. To do so, open the Unity Mod Manager UI and click the On-Off toggle. We can verify that the skin has been disabled because it no longer appears on any of the spawn DE2s. That said, the skin wasn't completely removed. It still appears on locomotives it was already applied to. However, we'll see the skin disappear if we reload. Once reloaded, the skin is no longer applied. To re-enable the mod, we'll simply open the Unity Mod Manager UI and click the On-Off toggle once again. Now when we spawn more DE2s, we'll see the custom skin once again. Now that we know how to temporarily disable a mod and re-enable it, let's learn how to uninstall a mod. To uninstall a mod, we'll need to return to the Unity Mod Manager installer application. Once here, we can right-click on a mod's entry and choose Uninstall. We'll know that the mod has been uninstalled when we see a success message at the bottom of the window and no longer see OK under the status column for that mod. Now when we reload the game, we can see that no skins have been loaded, and the reskin option hasn't been added to the comms radio. To reinstall a mod, all we have to do is right-click its entry and choose Install. We'll know it's been reinstalled when we see a success message at the bottom of the window and see OK reappear in the status column for that mod. Let's learn how to uninstall Unity Mod Manager entirely. To uninstall Unity Mod Manager, we'll come back to the Unity Mod Manager installer window. Back under the Install tab, we'll choose the Uninstall option. We'll know that it was uninstalled when we see a success message at the bottom of the window and no longer see a number next to in-game version. Now there's one last thing we'll need to cover before we're through, and that's how to uninstall BepInEx. If you've been following along with Derail Valley modding since the release of Simulator, you'll know that the community briefly switched to the BepInEx mod loader. If you're one of the many folks who installed BepInEx while that's what the community was using, you'll need to uninstall it before you install Unity Mod Manager. To do so, open your Derail Valley install directory. You can find that by going to Derail Valley in your Steam library, clicking on the cog button, going down to Manage, and choosing Browse Local Files. Once here, we can uninstall BepInEx by simply selecting the BepInEx folder, the doorstop config.ini file, and the winhttp.dll file. You can select multiple files at a time like this by holding down Control while you click each one. Then, simply right-click and delete, and now you're ready to install Unity Mod Manager. So that's a wrap. We learned how to install Unity Mod Manager, install code mods, install content mods, configure our mods, temporarily disable mods, uninstall individual mods, and uninstall Unity Mod Manager as a whole. We also learned how to uninstall BepInEx, for those of you who may have installed it while the community was briefly using it. I hope this video has been insightful and has helped you with your Derail Valley modding experience. If it has, be sure to leave a like, and the algorithm thinks you'd like to watch this video next.